Today, we are talking about the idea of caregivers helping other caregivers. Many times, as a caregiver, we can feel frustrated, exhausted, very alone, and sometimes a little depressed. I'm Pamela D. Wilson. My website is pameladwilson.com. On there, a lot of helpful information for caregivers and aging adults. Many of you know that I do a weekly radio show that turns into a podcast. And last spring, I had the privilege of interviewing Dr. Christopher Fagundes from Rice University. He is a researcher on caregiver stress. And today I'm here to talk to you about a research study that he is doing and Rice University is doing in conjunction with the National Institute on Health. In this video, in the post, there is a link to information on how you can learn more about this caregiver study. It's a study for spousal caregivers of people with Alzheimer's and dementia, and how the effects of COVID has affected the care that you give, how it's affected your health and your well-being. It's a remote study, so you can be anywhere and participate. The link in this video post goes to a page directly on the Rice website where you can put in your information. There is also a phone number in this video post, but I will read it to you. It's 832-819-4297. You can call that number to find out more about the research study and be a caregiver helping other caregivers. On that note, I want to talk a minute about my caregiver support group on Facebook. It's called the Caregiving Trap. You can also join that group. And in that group are caregivers helping other caregivers. Now, many caregivers in that group eventually lose the person for whom they're caring, and they think, well, I guess the group's not for me anymore. That group is still for you. Other caregivers can learn so much from your experiences as a caregiver and from everything that you went to. So if you are in my group and you have lost a loved one, consider sticking around. Consider being a caregiver who's willing to help other caregivers learn from your experiences and everything that you've been through. Because as a caregiver, you are valuable to other caregivers. You can help other caregivers. Join the group, stay in the group. And also check out this research study. Share information about this study with other people that you know who may be a spouse caring for someone with Alzheimer's and dementia. You can also visit my website, pameladwilson.com, go to the media tab and click on the Caring Generation radio show. If you want to listen to my previous interview with Dr. Christopher Fagundes of Rice University, again, visit my website, share this information with other caregivers you know. There are so many caregivers out there looking for a little bit of hope, help, and support. I'll see you again soon in another video.